Hello, my name is Jimmy Costello from the NX product marketing team, and today we're going to be reviewing how to upload your Designcenter data to Teamcenter Active Workspace. Whether you're working on single parts or complex assemblies, proper data upload is crucial for maintaining your design integrity and collaboration workflow. In the next few minutes, we'll walk through the essential steps to ensure your data is correctly stored, managed, and accessible in Teamcenter. We'll cover basic uploads, assembly handling, and key best practices. Let's go ahead and get started. To begin, the first area we're going to focus on is uploading a single unmanaged part. Having an unmanaged part means that your file currently exists only on your local system or network drive and hasn't yet been stored or tracked in Teamcenter. When you properly upload your Designcenter data, you ensure that all design files, whether single parts or complex assemblies, are centrally stored and managed. This prevents data loss, maintains a single source of truth for all design iterations, and eliminates inconsistencies that can arise from working with local unmanaged parts. You'll typically see these files with a .prt extension in your file explorer, and they won't have any Teamcenter ID or revision information associated with them. Let's walk through the process of getting this part into our managed environment. To begin, we have two options. We can either select Save As or select Assign Teamcenter ID to unmanaged parts. However, both of these choices will bring us to the same window when we are working with an unmanaged part in a managed environment. Once the dialog window is open, we can begin to set our save settings. You'll notice several key fields that need our attention: the ID, name, and revision. We can double-click in any of these fields to automatically generate the data. The ID is a unique system-generated value for internal tracking, ensuring each object is distinct in Teamcenter. For the name, enter a descriptive title that clearly identifies your part. Both of these fields are searchable for easy retrieval. The revision field represents the starting point of your part's lifecycle. While most organizations begin with either A or 1, this letter or number will progress each time you create a new revision, helping track the evolution of your design. If you have a specific revision, like B instead of A, you should enter that revision value before assigning it. And although we're working with a CAD design item type today, clicking the dropdown shows us the full range of item types available in Teamcenter. One other nice option we have is to save our items to existing projects to promote organization and consistency in our work. Projects also act as a security feature. If someone isn't part of a project, they won't be able to find or even know about the items assigned to that project. At the bottom of the window, you'll see a folder field where you can specify the Teamcenter location for your part. Make sure to select an appropriate folder where your team can easily find this part later. If you want to maintain the same folder structure as your local files, you can check the Maintain Original Folder Structure box. Once we've filled in all required fields, we can select OK to proceed with the upload. Now that we've uploaded our part, we can now also see that our file name has changed to reflect our new ID, name, and revision. The next thing we're going to look at is uploading assemblies into Teamcenter. While we just saw how to handle individual parts, assemblies require us to maintain the relationships between components. The Import Assembly tool streamlines this process, allowing us to bring in entire assemblies while preserving their structure. This is the preferred method for bringing NX data into Teamcenter. First, we're going to begin by selecting our assembly from our local save point. After this, we'll receive a notice informing us that some of these items already exist, and we have the option to reuse them rather than creating new save points. We'll select No to create new instances, allowing us to maintain separate revision control for these components. Now we can see a list of all of our assembly's components with IDs, names, and revision letters. Using Ctrl-C and Ctrl-P on our keyboard, these columns or cells can be copied over from one location to another, making the naming process efficient if your parts had previously been named. To see more information on these parts, we can scroll to the right. You might notice that our Teamcenter information column is currently filled with question marks. To fix this, we can select Validate Teamcenter Information, and the proper designation will be recorded. One other nice trick to make your naming system efficient is to use the Find and Replace tool, which can be pulled up using Control F on your keyboard. This makes removing .prt from names and replacing underlines with spaces a much quicker process. Another way to add additional information is in the secondary attributes section, which allows us to include important metadata like material properties, design specifications, or custom fields that your organization might require for proper documentation and searchability. Before we exit the window, it's also important to note we can add any of our parts to existing projects or replace them with existing parts that are already within Teamcenter. It's important to select these settings before selecting the data to import if you want each part to come with these values already set. Once we have hit OK, we can now go off and look for our items in our new assembly to make sure everything was properly uploaded. First, we should open Teamcenter from the resource bar on the left side of our screen, and then we can use the search tool to look up a part ID for an item like our gear motor assembly. With our assembly now verified in Teamcenter, we can access all component information, manage revisions, and proceed with any necessary design modifications. In conclusion, in this video, we've covered the essential workflows for managing our Designcenter data in Teamcenter Active Workspace. We started with the basics of uploading single unmanaged parts, learning how to assign proper IDs, names, and revisions. We then progressed to handling more complex assemblies using the Import Assembly tool, which maintains all component relationships and structures. And throughout the process, we've seen how to validate Teamcenter information, work with secondary attributes, and verify our uploads. These fundamental skills will help ensure your design data is secure, organized, and accessible to your entire team. I'd like to thank you for your time and attention.